Aung La N Sang, the one middleweight and light heavyweight world champion. Myanmar's first ever world champion of any sport. An icon, a superstar, a hero to the Myanmar people. The 30th of June, 2017, the night that changed Aung La's life forever. A rematch against ONE Middleweight World Champion, Vitaly Bigdash. Aung La lost to the Russian earlier in the year. But with the courage and determination of a world champion in his heart, Aung La didn't hesitate to step back into the circle with the familiar foe. This time, performing in front of his loving countrymen in Yangon, Myanmar. Go!
World middleweight title on the line. It continues to be deafening around us. The excitement at fever pitch, these two big men in the center of the cage. And it's Bigdash, who won't give any ground going backwards just yet. And then as I speak, he just drifts off to take a moment. Sends out that left jab. Aung La looks strong, he looks broad across the shoulder.
Aung La's got to get moving. He cannot stand in the middle of the cage in one spot and allow Vitaly Bigdash to set up some of those big strikes.
Just as you started saying that, Mitch, Bigdash landed a little short right hand to the temple just to show us all what he can do. If you don't use your judgment, your sense of distance correctly, and he comes round with a flashy spinning back kick that Aung La just stepped out of range for. A left hand from Aung La N Sang.
Both traded hooks there on that exchange. Vitaly Bigdash loves to showcase those kicks coming from a karate background.
And you can see that the size of these men means that when they land big. There's no flicking punches here. These are heavy punches that are being buried into the target. And that punch greeted with rapturous reception by the fans here.
That's what Aung La has to do. He has to increase the volume of these punches. Do not let Bigdash get comfortable and start unloading on him.
Right hand from Aung La N Sang. And listen to the fans. Five-minute rounds. So potentially here, 25 minutes. They've done that distance once. Bigdash, the winner by decision. But in that fight, Aung La N Sang didn't have a proper training camp, but he's showing now that he did have a good camp, and he's caught Bigdash with the left hand. Yuji Shimada's poised. Bigdash is very durable, but Aung La N Sang continues to rain down the punches. Bigdash looks composed. His body is being contorted in all kinds of shapes as this crowd goes absolutely mad around this arena. Bigdash tries to pull him in, but more heavy blows from the Burmese fighter. Lefts and rights. Bigdash covers up, throwing nothing back. Shimada continues to look very closely indeed. Bigdash pulls him in by the neck, trying to cut that distance down, but the big punches continue to come in. The crowd absolutely baying for this fight to finish.
Steve, we know about Bigdash's durability. Aung La has to be very careful and not to gas himself out. It's happened before to Bigdash's opponents. They sense a weakness, he gets dropped, and then they gas themselves out attacking and burning themselves out. Bigdash is extremely durable. Look
at huge elbow from Aung La N Sang, landed flush on the jaw of Vitaly Bigdash. But you're absolutely right, Mitch. He is so durable, the Russian, in this situation. We've seen it before.
He has to be very careful. Aung La has to brace himself and realize he can't finish. He's got to slow back down. Bigdash is going for the attacks, but I think Bigdash is still hurt.
He doesn't show any sign of wanting to get up just now. Come on back down, he says, beckoning him in with his hands.
Look how composed Bigdash looks.
And Yuji Shimada, the only man in that cage who can bring Bigdash to his feet, but he doesn't look too keen to stand up, does he? And you might be right, Mitch, he may be carrying some kind of an injury.
I think he's still hurt. Those were some big shots landed by the Burmese Python.
Big right hand again. And one from Bigdash as well.
Fans
going going crazy as we enter the final 50 seconds. Aung La N Sang lands a couple of decent uppercuts inside, but Bigdash is so durable. Comes back with punches of his own. Aung La N Sang with an elbow downwards in its motion onto the head of Bigdash. And it's the Russian going backwards, and you don't see that too often. What a thrilling 5 minutes. I'm sad to tell you that there's only 25 seconds left of this opening round.
Don't worry, Steve. We still got 20 minutes left of this world title fight.
This crowd making more noise than I've ever heard at a mixed martial arts event anywhere in the world.
I thought the roof was about to pop off this place.
Right, left, right from Aung La N Sang. He even has time to adjust his hair. And that is the end of an absolutely thrilling action-packed round. And look how much these fans appreciate that.
What a round, Steve. Bigdash got dropped. Aung La jumped all over him. But look at him, he looks composed. He looks okay. Let's take a look. Look at that overhand right. Slips through the guard of Bigdash and lands a nice four-punch combination. I like the hammer fist there at the end. But the composure of the champion, able to relax himself, realize, and we've seen this before. We've seen Bigdash get dropped on multiple occasions, but still keep himself together, come back and win. Don't count the champion out, but take a look at the challenger, Steve.
When Vitaly Bigdash made his walk to the cage, we wondered, didn't we, aloud, whether we were going to see another Bigdash spirit fight. Well, that first round is showing us every piece of evidence that we're about to. Bigdash opens his arms out and encourages the crowd to get even louder, if that is at all possible. He's enjoying the atmosphere just as much as everybody else is, by the look of things. Second round.
Aung La's confidence has got to be just as high as the energy inside this stadium. Good movement, very relaxed, coming from Aung La.
Just shakes his arms out just to get a bit loose, and then looks for a big right hand, but Bigdash quick, nimble, round the back. Now what
nice
can he do here, Mitch?
Rip, that was a beautiful takedown. He's kind of got on the side. Aung La's going to turn into that.
Oh, strong man, turn around. The noise absolutely deafening around and above us. Elbows from Aung La N Sang, but Bigdash is strong, and he gets up once more.
He just stands up, pure strength to get back to his feet from the champion.
Aung La N Sang is cut around the mouth, nothing too serious, I would think. Something that maybe might affect him as the fight goes on.
Bigdash pressing the challenger up against the cage. Has one underhook there on the left side. Aung La's posturing the head out, framing off, and his short elbows are landing on Bigdash.
Doesn't the Burmese fighter look composed though? Not unsettled at all, not rattled whatsoever, as this crowd make more noise than we can really tolerate here at cage side.
Immediately, the People's Champion gets right to the center of the cage, starts to measure out those strikes.
Bigdash shaken slightly there, not in any hurry to get back and engage again.
Bigdash does not look fully recovered. He seems a little bit off, just slightly askew, but that could be his that could be part of the play. That could be part of his tactic to lure Aung La into a false sense of security.
Superb left hand from Aung La N Sang. He's picking off Bigdash almost at will at times. But this man has superhuman abilities.
Again, look at that. Shoots in, takes the back of Aung La. But Aung La is a wizard in the grappling exchanges. He's possibly threatening out the Kimura there. Nice takedown from the champion to get the back of the challenger. Got both hooks in. The choke looks like it's in. He's flattening him out, Steve.
He's giving it up. In come the punches instead.
Those big shots. You can hear the thud.
The left arm looking to go around that throat once more, but again, Aung La N Sang has his arms in the way.
Aung La, he's got to posture now. He's got to try to work back up, but that's so difficult when you have a man the size of Bigdash on top of you.
Can't use the cage to lever himself up, remember. He can't grasp the cage with his hands. That has to use leg strength, but as you say, Bigdash is just sitting on him.
You can see him start to shrug those shoulders up and slowly start to move. Bigdash is going to want to pull his back away from the cage and stay in this top position.
Aung La N Sang just looks aside to his corner men, looks at the crowd as if he had time to do such a thing, but he looks remarkably composed. All the while taking punches to the left side of his body, and they'll be hurting. Vitaly Bigdash is a big man, and Yuji Shimada wants to see action in the center of the cage. Entertaining, but is that the right call, Mitch?
I don't know. Yuji's not giving these guys much chance to work. Bigdash was landing the punches, but it wasn't enough for Yuji Shimada. He wanted these guys on their feet.
Aung La N Sang, center cage. Vitaly Bigdash roaming around the periphery. Big right hand from Aung La N Sang, and he backs off after having sent it in. And a huge right hand from Vitaly Bigdash, exchanging single blows. Final minute of the second round now.
Good head movement by the challenger, and there is that left high kick.
And listen to this crowd. Uppercut inside from Aung La N Sang as Bigdash pushes him up against the cage wall.
Let's see what Bigdash can do. He's got him pressed up against the cage. He's got about 30 seconds to work. This is a bit closer than the first round. We've seen a lot more control from the top position from Bigdash. Again, we're not judging these fights round by round. This fight is judged on a whole, and we still got three rounds to go.
If it goes that far, big, big elbow and forearm from Bigdash, connecting with Aung La N Sang, just above his right eye. No sign of any cut there, though, just yet. Despite the punishment being taken, the second round is over, 10 down. 15 to go. I know it's difficult to judge while you're commentating, Mitch, but has Aung La slightly got the edge after 10 minutes?
Oh, look at that beautiful inside trip there to have Bigdash get on top, get the back. Aung La does the right thing, goes belly to belly there, and then controlling a lot of the positions because of the damage and the significant strikes landed in the first round. We gotta give a slight edge to Aung La, but Bigdash is starting to regain the composure. And what's the word we used? Durability, Steve.
That's what Vitaly Bigdash is all about. Those submission attempts would certainly have brought him back into the contest, but perhaps, dare we speculate, perhaps the Burmese Python with the edge. 15 minutes still to go. And it was in the third round, you might recall, of their first contest that Vitaly Bigdash connected with a stupendous kick to the head, which changed the course of that fight.
Round three,
fight!
Deja vu all over again, as Yogi Berra once said.
Pushes forward, you can hear the crowd getting behind their man as we're getting started in the third round.
Knee to the head from Vitaly Bigdash, and Aung La N Sang does not want to be caught by one of those. But look how composed he is. He's never very light on his feet, but planting those feet as he does gives him that extra power when he lands. He just does not look hurried, does he, Aung La N Sang? He'll do this at his own pace, despite the fact that the crowd are encouraging him to step up the effort.
That's what Aung La has to do. He has to start pushing, putting these combinations together. Bigdash doesn't want no more of it. Stand up with Aung La, immediately get this fight to the ground, and that's where he's having the most success. You would think that the striking specialist would want to keep it striking, but he's choosing to take this fight to the ground while the submission guy is having the most success on his feet.
Well, we recall how much he was stung in those first 5 minutes from the power of Aung La N Sang. No wonder then that he chose to take that driving takedown just 20 seconds ago and put the fight on the mat.
You can see Aung La has the overhook there, and that's prevented sending Bigdash from kind of posturing away, but a nice pull away from the cage to swivel Aung La's hips back down onto the mat. So Aung La's not able to use the cage to walk back up.
From sitting up to lying down, that's the position that Aung La N Sang finds himself in now. And he becomes increasingly exposed to those forearms on the face. We know he's got strength, and he puts himself back into, or tries to get back into that sitting position up against the cage wall. But Bigdash is strong.
Look at what he's doing to the wrist, Steve. He immediately takes that wrist away.
Almost
with the sweep.
Back and forth.
But this is what happened last time, Steve. In the third, fourth, and fifth round, it was Bigdash all over Aung La.
He's tremendously well-conditioned, the Russian.
He physically towers over his opponents, utilizing that strength and conditioning to really start to gain the edge in a lot of these later rounds.
As you can see from Bigdash's back, Aung La N Sang's forearms and the canvas, how much perspiration is now playing a part. Difficult to get a purchase on those bodies as you try and manipulate them into a position where you might try to take advantage. Slippery little suckers, these two now.
Immediate again. Yuji Shimada gets these guys back up. He's got to get these guys time to play on the
left
ground.
Left hand from Aung La N Sang. It was a straight left, and it sent perspiration flying from the head of Bigdash, who goes for the double leg and succeeds.
Nice double leg takedown. And that's where the champion's having a lot of success. He's got to be careful of that butterfly sweep coming from the challenger. But those hips are just so heavy. He's got so much pressure from the top position. Immediately he goes after the wrist, but Aung La is able to work his way back up to his feet.
And listen to what the crowd think of that tremendous leg strength. But will he get taken down again? He does, and these are point-scoring moves if he can work from position.
The champion again with the big takedown. He's got to get active, though. Otherwise, Yuji's going to pop these guys back up to their feet again. And I think that's what Aung La wants.
70 seconds left in round three. We are past the halfway mark of this contest.
You can see the challenger, Aung La, grabbing the head, keeping Bigdash close to him. And Yuji might stand these guys up again real soon. Bigdash has to be more active with the
strikes. And there's a lot of blood, Mitch, on Aung La N Sang's forehead. It looks to be either up in the hairline or to the left of his left eyebrow.
The hips are just floating around as Aung La is trying to leverage those hips up and possibly sweep or create a scramble. But look, Aung La is doing the right thing.
And the crowd get into it again.
30 seconds.
Final half minute of this third round.
Bigdash has got to be active. Yuji's going to stand these guys up with about 20 seconds left to go in the third, and we're almost in the championship rounds.
I'm sure Bigdash has seen that cut, and I'm sure he'll be looking to use his forearm as he has done so effectively in the past, and indeed earlier on in this contest. Aung La N Sang draws him in close to remove that leverage, take away the advantage. Well, the third round was a turning point in their first fight. Have we seen a similar turning point just now?
Look here, that's the story of this round, was that top pressure from the champion. A near sweep by Aung La, but Bigdash was able to stay on top. He needs to be a little bit more active when he does get on top. There's a brute strength takedown by the champion to end up on top. Now, who is gonna dig deep? Who wants it more? Will this crowd come into play and rise up and give Aung La the burst he needs? Can't wait to find out.
There's no question there are three parties involved in this fight. The two men in the cage and 12,000 or so outside of it, making so much noise.
Seconds out, please.
These are the championship rounds, the rounds that separate men from boys. These two have done it all before. Effectively, this now for these two is round nine. But we're not concerned with the first fight anymore. They start from scratch. Who's got the edge now? It was a good third round for Vitaly Bigdash. and Aung La N Sang may need to step up the pace. Easier said than done as the fatigue starts to set in. Big overhand right, heavy, heavy blow.
Aung La cannot allow Bigdash to pressure him up against the cage and get that takedown, because he's going to want to get this fight back to the ground, dominate the top position. Aung La's got to strike and move. Get on his bicycle, keep movement around, and not circle that strength side of Bigdash. Nice head kick there.
118 countries around the world tuning into this one. And if you're not familiar with our rule set, let me just let you know that the judges will score this fight in its entirety. So we're not going round by round. These fighters will be very aware, therefore, of how close this one is.
This is where Aung La is having the most success. He's utilizing that improved boxing. Now he's got the cardio to push this fight and the volume of his strikes up.
3 minutes 30 left in the fourth round. We've been on our feet for the first 90 seconds of this one. And that, you imagine, is where Aung La N Sang wants it to be.
This is definitely where he's been able to have the most success in this fight, is in the stand-up.
Nice high guard from the Burmese Python. Just cutting off those straight punches as Bigdash throws them in.
That left high kick comes out so fast. There's no setup at all. He just whips that leg up.
Oh, superb right uppercut from Aung La N Sang, and it caught Bigdash flush. And I think Bigdash for a moment wondered if maybe there was an eye poke. He's looking at the referee, not happy about something, but he's able and willing to fight on, though. He gave a nod to Aung La N Sang, saying, yep, let's carry on. Certainly it was a heavy blow that shook Bigdash's head backwards. And again, the perspiration went flying off, a left hand to the head, as the Burmese Python goes head hunting, and successfully so in the last 30 seconds.
I'd like to see him follow up, because as he's throwing these strikes and these combinations, Bigdash is kind of covering up. If he would punctuate it with a leg kick or a body shot, he may be able to find a weakness in the armor of Bigdash. Like he did in the first round, when he put together multiple strikes in that four-punch combination and sent him to the canvas.
2 minutes left in the fourth, Mitch. And Aung La N Sang. Yuki Shimada warning Vitaly Bigdash. I'm not quite clear what that was about.
Action.
Oh, okay.
Yuji Action Shimada wants just that.
Okay.
He wants these guys to put on the fight that we saw in the first.
And he replies with a nice crisp little right hand to Aung La N Sang's jaw. And they clash heads as they come together. No damage, though. 1.5 minutes left of this fourth round. Aung La N Sang still able to bounce on his feet every now and then, showing that he's benefited from a full camp this time, unlike in their first fight when he took the fight at only 10 days' notice. Vitaly Bigdash, again, communicating only with Aung La N Sang, says, watch those fingers, you're coming very close to my eyes, if not going in them. No timeout injury, though.
1 minute left in round number 4.
You can see Aung La try to frame off, create a little bit of space, and he did open up his hands. He might have brushed slightly, but I don't think there was any malicious intent on his part. But Yuji again consistently pushes forward. No takedown attempts from the champion this round.
Mitch, a little over 5 minutes left of this contest. What does Aung La N Sang need to do to capture the judge's eye?
He's got to put these punches together in bunches, multiple hit combinations. Now he's only throwing 1 and 2 punch combos. If he puts them together, Bigdash covers up and it creates a lot of openings for him.
You can see fatigue is starting to set in.
I think it's been there for a while, but these fighters are reaching down deep and displaying the heart of a warrior.
The hearts of a champion and a two-time now challenger. Who will come away with the belt around their waist? 5 minutes left to go. another round of heavy blows. This time, most of it, if not all of it, Mitch, on the feet. And that's where Aung La N Sang wanted it to be. But as you said, did he throw enough in terms of combinations?
That round was almost dead even, very close. You've got the damage sustained by Bigdash in the first round. You've got the dominant top control in the second and third round from the champion. That fourth round could have been a wash, could have been even both ways. I think it comes down to the fifth and final round because I still believe this is anybody's fight.
And isn't that just the way we wanted it to be? After 20 minutes, everything to fight for in the final five.
I don't think anybody in this stadium would have it any other way.
Well, there may be a few thousand people behind you who would have preferred that it was over perhaps a bit quicker in that man's favor, but I'm sure they're enjoying the thrill, the excitement, the competitiveness. Fifth and final round. Vitaly Bigdash, the champion, to the left and now rear, right of your screen, in the foreground, Aung La N Sang.
See, it's that combination, it's those multiple strikes where Aung La's having the most success. It could be enough to take this fifth round if he continues to do it, because he's landing a lot of these strikes. They're stepping right past Big Dash's guard.
The crowd getting involved again. There can't be much in this fight. Surely the outcome will be determined in the next 4 minutes and 18 seconds.
We're past 45 minutes that these guys have been doing battle. The amount that you learn about your opponent in 45 minutes is a tremendous amount of time. Who has got the strategy of their opponent figured out enough to capture this prestigious middleweight world title?
Has the groundwork of Vitaly Bigdash made a difference? Has the fact that he's thrown punches in bunches made a difference? Has the strong, damaging single punches of Aung La N Sang, particularly in those first 10 minutes, made a difference? All will be told there. A superb example of the power that the Burmese Python can unleash on the champion.
Nice takedown defense from the challenger. Reaching down deep. That's what he needs to do. Multiple strike combinations. He's putting those punches together. Stop the takedown. Keep this on the feet. Unload those combos.
And that injury on the left side of Aung La N Sang's face continues to show visible signs of trouble. Brings up that left leg to the side of Bigdash's face.
Aung La taking a page from the champion's book by throwing that no-show leg kick, left high kick.
Big opportunity here, Mitch, as you watch it, for somebody just to be a little bit busier and show the judges that they are the ones who deserve the win.
See, Aung La is getting success when he throws multiple strikes. The third strike is landing. Big takedown attempt from the champion.
Will that make the difference? They know that something small will decide the margin.
Aung La's got to get back up to his feet.
Keep going.
This could be it for the challenger unless he can work his way back up. Did he do enough in the early rounds?
I think the crowd are baying for Yuji Shimada to ask them to get back onto their feet.
Nice scramble to use the cage to get back up to his feet from Aung La.
Yuji separates them, and he will indeed take them to the center of the cage. The crowd love it. Mitch, there's 2 minutes left. Everything to fight for.
What does Bigdash have left in the tank? What can Aung La draw from this crowd to possibly see a title shift? Oh, big takedown from Bigdash again with a very awkward double leg takedown. But again, because of these unique variations of these takedowns that are coming from the champion, he's able to get this fight back down to the ground, and he's nowhere near the cage. So Aung La is going to have to create a scramble, have to create some movement, or tie up Bigdash like he's doing and hope Yuji pops him back up.
80 seconds left. It's going to be difficult without Yuji's help for Aung La N Sang to get back on his feet and show us what he can do.
In position, boss! Boss! In position!
just staying active enough. That body head, body head, body head.
And final round.
We got 1 minute to go in the world championship tilt.
Vitaly Bigdash, unbeaten at 9-0. This is his second defense of the world title he won in a thrilling contest against Eagle Spirit. Here in a contest just as thrilling. And with the added noise of the fans here that are right behind the challenger. But has he done enough in the final 30 seconds of this contest with his back to the canvas?
See, Aung La's active from the back. He's trying to move, he's trying to create space, but the champion has given him no room to breathe. Consistently, body-head combinations, staying active enough so that Yuji is forced to let him stay in the position.
Final seconds of this contest, and this one will go to the judges. The fans here agree with you. Whoever wins, how about Vitaly Bigdash against Aung La N Sang 3?
That fight was worth the price of admission for all 12,000 in Myanmar. Look at some of this past action. Just trading shots, standing in the middle of the cage and letting it all go. But is the striking of Aung La enough to counter the ground control and ground and pound from the champion?
It's easy to get carried away by the fans here and their support and the story that could be unveiled if Aung La N Sang wins this. But how about Vitaly Bigdash coming into this arena with everybody against him, showing strength and bravery, commitment? Has it been enough? Anthony Sun Tai is about to tell us.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Tet Teza, Managing Director of AGD Bank. Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner. And you won!
Law shocked the world once again in November of the same year. He made history by competing in ONE Championship's first ever super bout. His opponent, the hulking powerhouse, four-time Muay Thai and kickboxing heavyweight world champion, Alon Galani.
Showing him, he knows the power in the hands of Aung La gentlemen. Your referee, Mr. Olivier Coast, put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 31 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of guillotine choke, Aung La N Sang!
Aung La's versatility, matched with his undeniable stardom, is nothing short of breathtaking. Aung La's drive to grow and be the best martial artist on the planet led him to one of the greatest achievements any martial artist could ever dream of, a world title in a second division. Standing in Aung La's way of claiming the ONE Light Heavyweight World Championship, South American heavyweight champion, Alexandre Machado.
The biggest star, pop culture star in Myanmar, and Alexandre Machado of Brazil. Can he possibly tap out Aung La N Sang? A chance go up for Aung La early.
Seeing that size discrepancy you were talking about, Michael, look how big Machado is. Aung La's pressing forward.
Look out for the right hand, the big chub thumper on Aung La N Sang. Roundhouse kick from Aung La. Machado's got to get this contest to the ground. Even he knows it. He said to us yesterday, I can't match Aung La standing. I need to get it down. But once I'm down, that's my world.
But the Burmese Python has got such slick submission skills. And he's also got really good wrestling. He's got good takedown defense. He can push opponents. He's got huge power.
Oh, the big kabuki!
The medal for this match, please welcome once again Telenor Myanmar. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coast, has put a stop to this contest after 56 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of knockout, your ONE Middleweight and new ONE Light Heavyweight World Champion, Aung La N Sang!
Myanmar's first and only ever world champion of sports!
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.